Hey Star Wars fans, and a FlagEye.net video review. This time, if you've ever known the Galactic Heroes line by Hasbro, which was a small line of clones and aliens and all sorts of stuff from the various movies in Star Wars, they've upgraded it from Galactic Heroes to this new line, which is called Play School Heroes. And yes, this is a little bit old for me, but I couldn't resist. Darth Vader and a Stormtrooper, come on, who's going to resist this? Cool as hell little small pieces of plastic, $10 they are available here for. I think they're a little bit cheaper overseas in the US, maybe about $8 or so, maybe less. These guys, and we'll show them in just a second, are awesome. They're great little pieces, great little replacements for the Galactic Heroes line. Come with a little bit more articulation, some pluses and minuses in some ways, but there's a little bit of text about the figures themselves. Yada yada, join the force. And a cool little piece there on some of the other figures, Han Solo, Chewie, a very buff 3PO, and a Land Speeder and a Falcon. We've got a little bit of a mini preview of a Falcon, which was in stores. We can give you a little review of that. I love the way it says, product shown in a fantasy situation. So, very cool. So there's some of the others there. I'm not really going to be picking these guys up, just wanting to pick up a couple of them. And I'll show you a few in the next review or so, but you can pick up... Whoops, let me focus on all of it. There we go. Yoda and Luke Skywalker. A very cool looking Yoda, I have to say. Quite a buff Luke. Incredibly buff on steroids, Jar Jar and Anakin. And C-3PO is going to kick your ass. Kind of huge big guy. Look at the shoulders on him and the palms in an R2-D2. So very cool. So if you want to look at more, playschoolheroes.com. Have that online. And that's the pack. Now, one thing about the pack, just before we show you the figures, is the packaging itself. If you're really into this kind of stuff, the come this time, this is the first time I've ever seen Hasbro use, instead of plastic, they've actually used pieces of recycled cardboard. So this is actually, instead of being plastic cords, those ones that you can never cut unless you've got a knife, this is now paper. It's been really finely twined and pulled together, so still damn hard to get the package, but there we go. Some interesting fanboy metadata about the packaging. One other thing is that this small card here, which mentions a tearaway character card, unfortunately it's a bit crap, because that's all you get. It's just a piece of cardboard and there's nothing else, so not really a great feature, but if you really wanted it, there you go. It's got an extra piece with some nice artwork on the box. Enough of me, on with the figures. Darth Vader, here he goes. And pretty much not a million miles off the larger Play School version. There was a larger version of this guy many years ago, and he's pretty much on the money, very, very close to that. In terms of what we've got of articulation, you've got articulation by swivel points at the shoulders, so each of them move, an articulated head, which just swivels again, no waist, but legs, so you can sit Darth down and look at those big chunky feet. How cool are they? He's got some size of feet, that's for sure. So, like a very cool little figure. It's a little dark there on that camera. Hopefully you can see that just up close. So, some nice added paintwork to it. It's been pretty much detailed. And again, look, for $10 for the Stormtrooper and a Darth Vader, who can resist? I couldn't anyway. So, it's a really nice detailing and some effects. It's got a soft goods cape. Looks particularly good and floats around and does the job. In the back of it, not much else to show you. The lightsaber doesn't come out of his hand, it's actually fixed in and moulded. But again, we do get, I should have pointed out, actually swivel wrists on that one there, and on both sides actually. So, really pretty cool articulation considering the Galactic Heroes line normally did come in at $10 for us before anyway. So you're getting an extra chunkier size of figure, and I'll show a comparison to another Galactic Heroes line if I show you this guy again. In terms of height, a little bit more plastic for your money, plus articulation. So, pretty cool all round. So that's Darth. Pretty cool little figure all over. And one that I really like. It's very, very cool. And the other one, which is just the absolute must-buy for me, was one Stormtrooper. And he's very, very cool. Some very simple stuff done here. Obviously just black and white. Sorry, black paint on the white plastic itself. So not a great deal to add in terms of things like Darth Vader's control panels and lights and switches, so it's all really pretty simple on this one. Blasters molded into the hand yet again. In terms of articulation, we just have swiveling side to side. There's no other movement. The shoulders are actually ball jointed and swivel. So basically ball jointed all over. Very, very cool for a figure this size. And again, lots of movement there. Swivel wrist once more. No waist articulation, obviously, but you do get the leg, that kind of big sit-down kind of look again. So great little figures. Very, very cool indeed, I have to say. So imagine this one will sell out the most as people try and get army builders or stormtroopers, but they're very, very cool pieces. If you're anything like me, I've got a little stormtrooper shrine of tons of figures in different sizes, and he's a great one to add to collection. I really recommend you pick this one up, even if you're a big kid, or it's something maybe at your desk at your office or whatever it may be. It's just a cool figure. It's an awesome piece. Great one for kids, obviously. It's pretty chewable, and you know, you can chuck it around the room, and it's solid. It's absolutely solid, and that's the point for this line, is it's really aimed at much younger kids. But a great introduction to Star Wars, and start your kid off the right way. Give them a good Star Wars education by giving them toys nice and early. So there we go. That was Stormtrooper and Darth Vader from the Play School line. So hope you can pick them up. $10 in our stores here, and I think a little bit cheaper around the world. Let us know what the prices are for you in the comments below or on facebook.com/flyguy.net. We'll see you for another Jedi Force review coming up just next.